Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to tell a story with your data using the new Power BI integration in PowerPoint. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. First, before I get started, big shout out to Maya and her team for putting this together and making this real. Because before, there was a lot of challenges. If you had a Power BI report, you would need to head over to Power BI, either download the report or use some snipping tools to snag a copy, head back over and paste it in. That can be problematic because if the data changes, what do you need to do? Rinse and repeat, rinse and repeat, rinse and repeat, do the same thing, not efficient. Or you're doing a presentation, you're doing your thing, and somebody says, hey, Patrick, can you filter that by my department? And you go, I can't do that. It's a static image. No more. We don't have that problem anymore because of this new integration. So what you would do is you would open up, wait, enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. So head over to PowerPoint and go to insert. And you should see a little section for Power BI. Go ahead and click. It's gonna insert this little plugin directly on the page. What you need to do now is head to Power BI. Now, the Microsoft recommended approach is to click share. You can see everyone in your organization can see this link. Whatever you decide to do, what option you choose right here, it's gonna automatically share this with everyone in your organization. And you can change this if you want to. But before you do that, let's go back for 1 second. If I open up my slicer panel, there's no filters. So you can see that there's 138,000. If I choose like 2019, is 17,000. Remember that. Let's close the slicer panel. So if I choose share and keep this checkbox, and if you hover over the little information, it'll tell you. When it creates that link, it's going to hold all my changes. So now if I choose PowerPoint, when I grab this link right here, anyone in my organization that opens up that PowerPoint slide deck will be able to see that Power BI report. Or I can click open in PowerPoint and it'll automatically open up PowerPoint with everything all wired up for me. I'm just going to copy this link because I've already set this up in PowerPoint. So I'm going to paste this link in and click insert. Boom, like magic. You're gonna see my report appear in Power BI. I mean, in PowerPoint. Oh, it's so confusing. All these powers, power this, power that. Anyway, once you do that, you have full access to all the interactivity. So if I choose North America, it filters. If I choose, you know, Wyatt more, it filters. And you notice tooltip works. Everything completely works with this integration. Also, there's lots of options here. I can use the filter pane if I want to. I can go down here, I can reset the report, I can refresh the data, I can hide the filter pane. I'm gonna go ahead and hide the filter pane. Notice how my slicer panel, the value that I selected, is still persisted because I chose the checkbox, right? Include my changes. All of this works directly inside of PowerPoint. There's another little option here where I can clear out the data. And what that means, I wanna start with a new report. So it'll clear it out, bring a new URL, and then I can start from scratch. And then you can go learn more information about it. And then I can hide this at the bottom. Once I go over in the presentation mode, all that interactivity is still available. So let me show you. And so you can see right there, there's my tooltip. And if I choose a bar over here, everything filters. It's all completely interactive, whether I'm in presentation mode or if I'm in authoring mode, it all completely works. So this is all amazing. This is great. But then I had another question. I'm like, what if I want to set all my filters and everything and I don't want anyone to change what's on the screen? Can I make this a static image? Sure. Let me show you. There's this little flyout right here, and sometimes it's a little hard to get to it, but if you click it and you can expand this out, you can choose show as saved image. So once I do that, all the interactivity that's available in authoring mode or presentation mode goes away. So it's pretty much saved as a static image at that point. We don't wanna do that, right? We wanna make sure we have the full fidelity here. So I'm gonna uncheck that. One thing to note about the static images, that feature is only available in the PowerPoint desktop application. It's not available in the web. So if you try to do it in the web, you need to come down and run it in desktop. All right, the last thing I wanna show you. Somebody asked a really interesting question. They were like, hey, what if I just wanted to show one of these visuals during my PowerPoint presentation? You could absolutely do that. You see this little focus mode right here? If I expand this out and then collapse it down, it automatically orientates to the size that I have. And boom, I just have that particular visual showing. And I can copy and paste this and show other individual visuals. I don't know why that won't go away. Go away. This will eventually go away. This filter will go away. And then I can add other context and text just specific to that bar chart. All right, what do you guys think? You got any questions? You got any comments about this integration? I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. You like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.